if the Obama administration's de facto policy of erasing our borders by refusing to enforce our immigration laws wasn't harmful enough, they've announced plans to increase our intake of economic immigrants from Syria and other U.S. In other Muslim countries by falsely labeling them refugees and claiming we have a duty to protect them under the 1951 Convention on Refugees. It is, in fact, just one more convenient lie used to conceal the corrupt and sinister reality of what is really going on. And here to share their knowledge and insights about this racket are two real experts on U.S. refugee resettlement policy. 8 years ago, Ann Corcoran decided to investigate after the Virginia Council of Churches started settling refugees in nearby Hagerstown, Maryland. What she discovered led her to create and become the editor of the Refugee Resettlement Watch, a website where she investigates, tracks, and blogs on refugee resettlement activity across the country, and which has become a go-to resource for local communities that are trying to fight this.
But Jim didn't get to it, but let me just mention to you that there are pockets of resistance forming across America, and we could sit here in the Washington area and learn about all these statistics and talk to each other, but the people who are really doing the work on this issue right now are out in the communities across America. We won't have time to talk about it today, but just in the last 2 weeks, grassroots activists confronted Allentown, Pennsylvania on the Syrian refugee issue, confronted Pickens County, South Carolina, and Redlands, California. That's where the work is going to be done on this. And I wanted to do something a little different today because I thought you might be getting bored. I'm going to test you. Now, these people that I'm going to show you are just the 10 I have picked who are changing America by changing the people. And it's time that we all understood who the other side is. This morning, Dan said, this is war. These are treasonous people. These are not humanitarian. The people I'm going to show you now. Now, we can quibble over, well, I like this person in the top 10, or I like that person in the top 10. You can pick your own top 10 people, but these are my top 10. And I haven't picked people like Senator Leahy, who's obvious, for example, as one of those changing America. How many of you heard of Saul Alinsky? Rules for Radicals? Good. How many of you know what Rule 13 is? You know Rule 13?
No.
Name and shame. That's the rule where he said pick a target and identify them and go after them. These are the enemy. These are my Rule 13 people. These are the people promoting mass migration. Oh, and let me make one other point about these people. They make no distinction between legal and illegal immigrants. They are all working for the same thing. They are changing America. They make no distinction. I think we have spent way too long talking about legal is sort of okay over here, but illegal is bad. These people are all working together. They make no distinction. They are changing America. So here we go. You're going to be tested. Okay, who do we have on the left? Raise your hand. Yes, from what state? Who's standing over his left shoulder? If you can name him, you get extra points. CARE, good for you. That's the director of CARE Connecticut. Blumenthal is now pushing for the expansion of the family reunification, the P3 program of refugees. He wants more family members of refugees brought here. Okay, so who's on the right? Raise your hand. Trey Gowdy, but I'm more interested right now in who's over his shoulder. Lindsey Graham wants more Syrians here. How many times have you heard Lindsey Graham say on TV lately, we have to fight them there so they won't come here? And now he's pushing for more Syrians to come here. It's insane. And Trey Gowdy just happened to be in this picture. But I have to tell you, I'm very disappointed in Trey Gowdy. He is chairman of the subcommittee responsible for the refugee program. He has new refugees coming to his town of Spartanburg, and yay, wrote a couple of letters, but he's not holding any hearing on this refugee program, and he is the chief member of Congress who could be holding oversight hearings right now if he wanted to. Yes, he should know better. Exactly. Okay, next. Now, it's going to get a little harder. The next one's pretty easy. Who's this?
Cecilia.
Yes, yes. Now, she works in the White House, as you probably know. She's from La Raza. She works as an Obama aide, and she helped craft Obama's Task Force on New Americans. Are you familiar with Obama's Task Force on New Americans? Good, because they're placing various programs, putting it in place now to put them in the DNA of government so that when Obama leaves, their plans will already be in place, including HUD housing and so on and so forth to diversify towns. I bet you don't get the next guy. Anybody gets the next guy, you're good. Who's talking to Hillary thinks he's cute? Anybody?
Miliband.
Who said that? Oh, Don. Don knows them all. This is David Miliband. He is the brother to Red Ed, who ran for Prime Minister of the UK. David Miliband is a Brit. He heads our largest refugee resettlement agency. He came over from the UK a couple of years ago. As you can see, Hillary thinks he's cute, but he also has friends in George Soros and Samantha Powers, and he is the first, and he makes, by the way, about $500,000 a year running the International Rescue Committee, which we fund largely with our tax dollars. And Miliband, let's see, what else was I gonna tell you about him? Yes, good. Oh, and the most important thing is he's the first one to come out recently pushing for us to take in 65,000 Syrians within 1 year, but now he's up the number to 100,000, and he's running around everywhere telling people we should be taking 100,000 Syrian, mostly Muslim refugees. Okay, who's this? He's a lobbyist for a major...
Applebee.
Yeah, good. Who got Applebee? Oh, very good. Roy back over here got Applebee. Yes, he is the lobbyist for the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops, and I want to emphasize over and over again, these groups, the refugee contractors like the bishops, they all lobbied for the Gang of Eight bill. They do not just work on refugees. And one of the things I have to say about Applebee, somebody should look into this. He wrote a big report in the winter of 2013, where he took the bishops down to Central American countries, and he came back and he authored a big report predicting that the unaccompanied alien children wave was going to start that summer. I think they were involved in promoting that. That's just a guess. I can't prove it. Okay, who's this? If you get her, this is good. Besides Don, anybody? Nobody. She's really critical. She is changing America for decades. What? Excuse me? Nope. Her name is Lavinia Limon. And Lavinia is the head of the U.S. Committee for Refugees and Immigrants. She's been in and out of the door to government ever since for her whole political career. She was Bill Clinton's head of the Office of Refugee Resettlement. She left that job, in other words, she was giving the grant money out, and then she became one of the leaders of the agencies collecting the grant money. And her vice president went in to become a government employee to give out the money to her organization. And now he's left the Office of Refugee Resettlement, and he's back there collecting the money. That's Eskinder Nagash is her vice.
Spell her last name.
L-I-M-O-N. And here's one of the things, before I keep going here, one of the things, excuse me?
Same person on each side.
Oh, yes, I just wanted to show you the many faces. There are more faces of Lavinia Limon over the years. Those are just two faces, I'm sorry. But anyway, when I get through my list here, the point I'm making on this list is I'm hoping that all of you who have publications or are out speaking will start focusing on these people. Okay, now this next one, if you get this, you're really good. Obama invited him on Air Force One. Hint, he talks a lot about seedlings and soil, but it's not a farmer. Anybody? Except Don. Don knows them all. This is David Lubell. He heads Welcoming America that Jim just told you about. He started his career with Welcoming Tennessee. I first heard about David Lubell in June of 2013 in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, when I went to an Office of Refugee Resettlement meeting, and his group was there, and they literally had a slide on the screen with a little plant growing out of soil, and they said that the immigrant was the little plant and we were the soil, and the immigrant was to be accommodated and the soil was to change to accommodate the immigrant. They literally had that picture. And that's the first time I had seen or heard about David Lubell. L-U-B-E-L-L. I have a few handouts here with these people for those of you who want them. His original funding came from the Soros, one of Soros's foundations, but he also gets federal grants now. And moving along here, we have, any guesses? This woman revolves in and out of the government door, too, between the contractor and the federal agency. Any idea?
Ann Richards.
Yes, very good. Who said that? Oh, just Don again. she's the Assistant Secretary of State for Population, Refugees, and Migration. She came from the International Rescue Committee, which is David Miliband's group. She was a vice president there. But previous to that, she was in the State Department. Then she went out to become a contractor, and now she's back in the State Department again. And she also, huh?
Last name?
Ann Richard, R-I-C-H-A-R-D, no S. This woman is rolling in money, and she commissioned a report that suggested Refugee Resettlement Watch and me be investigated by the Southern Poverty Law Center. Yes, I'm very proud. I really am proud of this, seriously. I found out lately they have mentioned me, and it's a great honor now to be recognized by them. This is Suzette Brooks Masters, and she oversees immigration grant making for the J.M. Kaplan Fund in New York City. And she paid the Hebrew Immigrant Aid Society, Melanie Nezer, Melanie would have been Jim's pick in the top 10, clearly. Melanie Nezer of the Hebrew Immigrant Aid Society, you can write her name down too. But Melanie wrote the $35,000 report that suggested, among other, that we all in these pockets of resistance be investigated. They call us pockets of resistance, by the way, anybody who asks about that.
30-page report, $35,000.
Right.
$1,000 a page. I like
Yeah, it'd be good, wouldn't it?
Conservatives get that kind of money.
Now, she's involved in a big powwow that's going to happen in New York City here in early December, where all of them are going to be there. La Raza, open borders, no borders, refugee contractors, and they're all going there, and they have a session designated to expose us, anybody who's questioning the refugee program. But the important thing about their big powwow is they are getting ready for the 2016 presidential election. That's what this is about. That's to get their marching orders for 2016. How about this guy? Mark Hetfield with the Hebrew Immigrant Aid Society thinks he's doing good work, and he's not, in my opinion. He's president of the Hebrew Immigrant Aid Society. It is one of the major, nine major federal resettlement contractors. His organization is paid millions every year to resettle refugees in the United States. He is not a friend of Israel, by the way. And he lobbied heavily, because I followed him, he lobbied heavily on the Gang of Eight amnesty bill, which I find an outrage that these groups get government grant money and at the same time they lobby for amnesty legislation. The Gang of Eight bill would have had additional funding for these refugee contractors because they're
say his name again.
Mark Hetfield, H-E-T-F-I-E-L-D. I did bring a few copies of my notes for if anybody's really interested, so you don't have to write it down if you're interested. Next, nobody's going to get this next guy. He got an award in 2013. He's an Obama Champion of Change. And who is he? Anybody? He's the state refugee coordinator for the state of Idaho. Idaho is being colonized as we speak. There's a very, very active pocket of resistance in Idaho. In Twin Falls, Idaho, the folks out there are doing a fabulous job in Twin Falls pushing back. But Jan Reeves is the state coordinator. He has been the state coordinator for 25 years. He's your typical ideologue, and he was honored by Obama as a Obama champion of change. Now, he might not be the worst state coordinator, but I just decided to throw in a state level person because I think you should know about them, that each, well, not every state, but most states have a coordinator. Jan Reeves, R-E-E-V-E-S.
J-A-N.
They're targeting everywhere pretty much. The only states that don't have refugees are Wyoming and Montana. I just have one more bonus picture for everybody, and you all better get this guy, okay? If you don't, you fail my test. What? Okay. I see. All right. Does everybody know who this is? You should. Yes. Good. Lots of people know that. Mark Potok from the Southern Poverty Law Center. So he definitely should be on the list. But anyway, that's really it. I think we're out of time, right?